Welcome back, Lancers. Today we are back again with another video, and today's video topic is the continue statements. In this video we will be covering topics like what is continue statement, how we use continue statement, what is the basic difference between break statement and continue statement, and also we will have our hands-on session on continue statement. So without further ado, let's get right into the video. So what is continue statement? By a basic definition, we can say that continue statement is used to bring the program control to the beginning of the loop. Now what do we mean by that? In a layman's word, or you can say in easy word, we can say that continue statement skips some lines of codes inside the loop and continue with the next iteration. Now let's first understand what the definition means. The definition means that if we have a loop from 1 to 5, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, then, and if we have attach the continue statement with the third iteration, you can see by 3 we have attached the continue statement, then what will happen during the time of execution? The program flow or the program control will print 1, 2. After that it will see that while printing 3, continue statement is called, and so it will skip that iteration and does not print 3 and move to 4 and 5. So what will be the output? The output will be only 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 4 and 5. 3 will not be printed. This is what continue statement is used for. Basically you can say that continue statement mainly used for a condition so that we can skip some codes. Here we have skipped the printing code, or you can say the printf statement. We can skip some code for particular condition. And what was our condition? Here, in this example, our condition was when I is equals to 3. This is what our condition was. That is why it doesn't print the value 3, or it doesn't iterate or execute the execution when I was 3. This is what continue statement is used for. Now let us see the control flow, or you can say the flow chart. The flow chart of a continue statement looks something like this. First of all, we have a loop here. You see, our control flow comes to our loop. After that, it checks. If the loop is false, then definitely it will terminate the program and the continue statement is unable to run. But if the loop statement is true and the program flow met with continue statement, then what will happen? It will see that if continue statement is there, it will not go to our code, but rather go to our loop and again iterate without executing the code. But if continue statement is absent, then, or you can see here, when continue statement is no, the code will be executed first and after that the execution of loop continues. So after summarizing, we can say that continue statement is used to skip few codes on a certain condition. Let's for say we have a condition of printing 1, 2, 5, and we have said that if I is equals to 3, then continue. What will this program do? This program will check whenever the value of I becomes 3, it will skip the codes that are in below this code, this continue statement. and it will again start from the iteration part. Now let us see the break and continue. We will compare both of them with a hands-on programs example. There we have two for loops here. Both are printing same values. What will break statement do if it is printed here? Let's say here we have a break statement, and what will this do? Basically, this will terminate this loop. Complete loop will be terminated, and the control flow will move to this loop. This is what break statement will do. But in continue statement, let's say here we have a continue, then this loop will not be terminated. Rather, only the statement where the continue is present. Let's say the program was something like this. If j is equals to 3, then whenever j becomes 3, this code will not execute. The hello will not print it, and then the continue statement will again iterate from j only. When the j will complete, after that I will be executed. This is what break statement and continue statement are differ from each other. Now let's move to our VS Code and do some practical hands-on on this topic, continue statement. So here we are back to our VS Code. Now we will program a very basic program to understand the continue statement much more effectively. Now let's first include standard io.h. these are the basic for every single program, and then int main. After that, what we will do here, we will make a looping statement. Let's take first iterator of integer type int i, and after that we will loop for I is equals to 1, I less than equals to 5, and I plus plus. And here we will print the value of I. See, now let's run this program and see what we are getting as an output. Here you see we are getting 1 2 3 4 5. We are getting each of the iteration, each of the values of I the program is going through. Here the value is first 1, after that it is going to 2, then 3, then 4, and then 5, and in each iteration I is printed along. But what if I write here, if I is equals to 3, let's for say, then continue. What will happen if I say something like this? According to the theory part, we have understand that this will print something like this: 1, after that it will print 2, after that when the I value will be 3, this is true, this condition is true, so the continue statement will execute. And why, as continue statement will be executed, it should not print this loop. But here you can see this if, or you can see the continue statement is after the printing statement. So as the theory says, the continue will not allow any execution of the programs after this continue statement. So here it will print 3 4 5. The 3 will be printed here. Let's see first. You see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3 was able to print here. You know why? Because continue statement was below printf I. So first the I was printed, and then it was checked that I was 3. Then continue will send the program flow to the for loop again and change the value of I. But what if I move this statement after continue statement, and if I run this one, you see This time our output skips the third value. It doesn't print the 3. The output is 1, 2, 4 and 5. The 3 is missing here. This is what continue is used for. With this, let's wrap this video. Thank you for watching. Peace.